Hello everyone, welcome to Unlock Maths. Today we have to find inverse Laplace transform of this given function. Here we can check that in denominator we have repeated quadratic factor, right? So it's good to use convolution theorem rather than partial fraction method for finding inverse Laplace, right? So we have to write down statement of convolution theorem. This theorem states that if we have inverse Laplace of two functions f of s and g of s, then inverse Laplace of their product can be found by using this integral, right? So here we have to use convolution theorem for finding inverse Laplace of this given function. So let's consider this f of s, this capital F of s, as a this given function. Now we have to write down given function f of s in two functions such that we can find their inverse Laplace easily. So we have to write down this is as a s+3 upon s² 6x + 5 into this s+3 upon s² 6x + 5. So let's consider this function. First function is f of s and this is g of s. Now here we got two same function f of s and g of s, right? So let's try to find out inverse Laplace of this first function f of s. So here L inverse of f of s is L inverse of this s+3 upon s² 6x + 5, right? Now here we can check that in denominator here we have quadratic factor, right? So here we have to adjust perfect square so that we can use inverse Laplace transform formulas, right? And we know for quadratic factor x² bx + c, for a perfect square we have, this is called as a third term, this is given by 1/2 into coefficient of this x and its square. So for this we have to adjust, we have to find out third term, this is given by 1/2 into coefficient of s, this is here we have 6, its square, right? So we got third term, this is as a 3² this is 9. So we got third term, this is as a 9. So we have to adjust 9 here, right? So we have this is s+3 upon s² 6x. We have to adjust, this is here 9, right? So we have to add here. So we have add 9. So we have to subtract this 9, right? And this 5 as it is, right? So we can write this is as a L inverse of s+3 upon, this is here we have, this is perfect square of s+3 its square, right? And this -9 + 5, this is here we have to write this is -4, right? Now we can write this is as a s+3 upon this s+3 its square, and this is here we have 2², right? Now we can check that here we have this function is of this type f of s+a, right? And we know that when we have to find L inverse of this f of s+a, we can find this is by using first shifting property of L inverse, and this is given by, yes, when we have this is plus a, we have to take this is e⁻⁸ outside, and this is here we have to write L inverse of f of s. This is first shifting property of inverse Laplace transform. Now here we have in numerator and denominator here we have s+3. So we can take this is plus 3 outside. So here we have to write down e raised to minus 3t. And remaining, this is L inverse of. Here we have s upon s square minus 2 square, right? And now we know that, yes, this is L inverse of cos of, yes, here we have s upon, right? So this is, and here we have minus sign. So this is L inverse of cos of h twice t, right? We have this formula L inverse of s upon s square minus a square. This is cos of h a t, right? This is the standard formula we have applied here. Okay, now we got this is L inverse of this f of s, right? We have to call this is as a f of t. Now, same here, we have to find L inverse of this next function g of s. And here we have g of s, this is same as f of s. Now, L inverse of g of s, this is L inverse of s plus 3 upon s square 6x plus 5, right? And L inverse of g of s, this is here we have g of t, and this is same as we have find this is here earlier. So what is here, we have to write down g of t as a e raised to minus 3t into cos of h twice t, right? So in this way we have find f of t and g of t, right? Yes, here we have find f of t and g of t, and now we are ready to apply convolution theorem, right? So for convolution theorem, we want f of u and g of t minus u, right? So here we have to write down this f of u by replacing this is t by u. So here we have f of u as e raised to minus thrice u into cos of h twice u, right? And g of t minus u is obtained by replacing this is t by t minus u. So this is e raised to, this is t minus u into cos of h twice t minus u, right? We can simplify further here. E raised to minus 3t, this minus gets inside. So here we have plus thrice u, same here, cos of h twice t minus twice u, right? So here we have find f of u and g of t minus u. Now we have to use this both value in given integral. Yes, here we have put down this value in this given integral. Now, this integral is with respect to u, right? So, we have to simplify this is. Yes, we have here e raised to minus 3t into e raised to thrice u, right? This is cos of h twice t minus twice u, right? Yes, we have applied the rule of indices here. So, this and this get cancelled. This is again by rule of indices, right? Here we can check that this integral is with respect to u, right? So e raised to minus 3t, this is constant. So we can take this is outside. So here we have outside this integral e raised to minus 3t, and inside this integral here we have cos of h twice u, and this is cos of h twice t minus twice u, right? Now we have to evaluate this integral. And here we can check that here we have product of hyperbolic function, right? For evaluation of this integral, we have to convert this product into addition or subtraction. For this, we have to use hyperbolic identity. This is cos of hx into cos of hy. And we know this is given by, this is 1 by 2 of cos of h x plus y plus cos of h x minus y, right? So we have to find out the value of this product here. Now we have to treat this is as a x and this is as a y, right? And we have to put down all this value here. This minus gets inside, so this is minus and this get plus, right? And now this is we get here 1 by 2 into cos of h twice t plus cos of h this twice u plus this twice u. This is here we have 4u minus twice t, right? So this is we have find the value of this product. We have convert this product into addition. Now we have to put down this value in this given integral. Now we have to evaluate this integral with respect to u. Here we have this 1 by 2, this is constant, so we have to take this is outside this integral, and we have to do the separation of this integral here. Now since this integral is with respect to u, so this is a constant, right? Cos of h twice t, and du its integral, this is u, and limit within 0 to t. Same here, integral of this hyperbolic cos, this is hyperbolic sine, right? So this integral is with respect to u. So here we have sine of h 4u minus twice t upon 4, right? And limit within 0 to t. Yes. So here we have write down integral of cos of hx. This is given by sine of hx, right? Now we have to put down the limit here, cos of h twice t, this is t minus 0 plus this 1 by 4, this is constant. Now we have to put down limit in u. So here we have for upper limit sine h 4t minus twice t, right? And for lower limit sine h, this is 4 into 0, this is 0, and this is minus twice t. Yes. So here on simplification, this is 1 by 2 into e raised to minus 3t. This is cos of h twice t into t, right? And this 1 by 4. So here we have sine h, this is 4t minus twice t, this is here we have twice t, and here, yes, this is minus sine h of minus twice t, right? And sine of minus theta is equals to minus sine theta, right? So we have to take this minus, this is outside here, then that will get plus, right? So here we have, yes, when we take this minus, this get plus. So on simplification, we get here, this is 2 times sine of h twice t. Yes, if you want, we can further simplify. This is here, we have L inverse of f of s into g of s, right? This is, we can take 1 by 2, this is outside. So here we have 1 by 4, e raised to minus 3t. And this is now, this 2 gets shifted here. So we have, this is twice t into cos of h twice t. And plus this is sine of h twice t, right? Yes. And we have find L inverse of this given function. This is here. So in this way, we have find L inverse of this given function by convolution theorem, right? So yes, that's it for now. See you in the next video. Thank you. Keep watching.